In this video, I will show you that how you can grab the valid license for free, and then we will configure the license file on our machine too. Important thing is that these licenses would be machine locked license. This means you cannot use the same license on more than one machine. This is not allowed. But you can grab the license for more than one machine for a fair use. So at the first step, you need to go at the licensing.intel.com page. This is the official Intel page for the licensing. So just type licensing.intel.com. Once you open the page, so this page will open that says this is Intel FPGA Self-Service Licensing Center. So if you are the previous user of this service, then you can just sign in with your login credential. But if you are using this form for the first time, or if you are using this service for the first time, you need to enroll first. So here is the option of enroll, and here is the option for the sign in. So first we are enrolled for the services. So here is the button that says enroll for Intel FPGA Self-Service Licensing Center SSLC. So you need to click on it. So once you click here, you will see this page that has the option of signing in, and you have the another option that says create an account. Because you are here to create an account, so click on this option that says create an account. So I've clicked it. Now once you click it here, then you will see this form that requires few of your details like your email ID, your first name, your last name, your locations, and the password. So fill the details, fill your email ID, confirm your email ID, give your first name, give your last name, select the preferred language, give your location, either you are in US or in India, anywhere. Give some password and confirm your password. Make sure while you are entering your password that should follow the required rules. That must be a lowercase character, there should be an uppercase character. It should have at least one number, one special character that should be in between 8 to 29 characters long, like that. If you wish to subscribe for the updates and notifications, you can check. Now next, click on next and verify your email. So once you click on here, then you will get the email with the notification and that having the verification code. So just open your email ID and search for the email. If you don't see the email from the intel.com, then in that case, just check for the spam folder as well. You might see that there. So once you look for the email and you get the verification code, just enter the verification code here and then click on create an account. So once you do that, now it's time to log in with your login credential. So now sign in, click on this option that says already enrolled, sign in here. So once you click here, so click on it, enter your password, then sign in. So once you do that, it will ask to verify your identity through or SMS message or the text message or through the call. So you can prefer whatever you want. If you want to get the SMS with the verification code, then select text, else you can select call as well. So once you do that, you will get the text or some code over the text message, or you will get this from the voice call as well. So I get it from the text message. I have entered it. Now click on verify. Now you have signed in on the licensing.intel.com. Now it's time to grab your license. So click on the option that sign up for evolution or no cost licenses. So click on that option. Then there are multiple applications that is listed here. We are looking for the Questa Intel FPGA Starter Edition license software Questa. This is free of cost, so I've chosen it. So select it and go next. So once you do that, you have the option of create a new computer. I'm getting this because I have already registered. I have already grabbed the license for one of my machine. This is listed here and I'm showing you for the another machine. So I will, just for the example, I'm clicking on the new computer. So once you click in here, click on next, and now you will see this form. So you need to give few of your machine details, because these licenses are machine specific. You can't transfer those licenses from one machine to another machine. I mean, you cannot use the same license for only two machines, because this is machine locked. So you need to give, you need to tell what is your machine name or what is your computer name, and you need to tell them that what is your primary computer ID. We will do that in some time. So in the next slide, I will be showing you how you will get your computer name on your machine and how you will get the primary computer ID on your machine, of your machine. Okay, suppose I have given some random name. So this is your computer name. I have selected NIC ID as a verification type. License type, choose fixed here. You will have the two options, that is fixed and float. And this is your machine identification details. And once you do that, click on save. So let me quickly go through you. If you don't know what is your machine name, then open the settings if you are using Windows 10 or Windows 11. So inside the settings, go to the account section, click on it. Once you do that, so you will see the accounts and Windows. So you will see this option, and here, just straight after this, you will see your PC name here. So just copy it from here and paste it in the form. Alternatively, you can check it from the command prompt as well. So open the command prompt and type the command system info and hit enter. So once you hit enter, you will see the option that says host name, and that tells you about your machine name. So just copy it from here and paste in your form. Now it's time to get your machine identification. For this, you need to open the setting once again and now go to the network and internet section. I'm connected to the Ethernet, so I've choose this option. If you are connected through Wi-Fi, then choose the Wi-Fi option. So click on the Ethernet option. So once you do that, you will see this page, and here just go down in the last and you will see the physical address bracket MAC. So this is 12 digit alphanumeric value. So this will be your NIC ID. So copy this and paste this in your form. Alternatively, you can check this from the command prompt as well. So open the command prompt and type the command ipconfig/all and then hit enter. So once you do this, go to the look for the area physical address, and you will see your NIC address or your MAC address here. This is 12 digit alphanumeric value. So copy this from here and now go to your form. So enter your computer name, enter, select the NIC ID, select the license type, and type your physical or primary computer ID, that is your MAC address. Note that when you're copying the NIC address or your MAC address or physical address from your computer, then remove the hyphen sign from this value. Otherwise, it might give you the error. Now, once you do that, click on save. Now select this option or select this computer, and then click on the terms and condition checkbox. So tick it on. Now, once you do that, click on the generate button. So this is the confirmation page that says your license generation request has been submitted successfully. For this is your reference ID for your license, and you will be receiving the license file to your email. So now once you get this page, or you get this notification, then look over your email ID and look for the email from the intel.com. It will look something like this. So it is came from the intel.com, that having your basic details which you have entered, like your computer name, you have entered your primary machine IDs, etc., and you will get the licensing file here as well. So you need to download this license file and save it in your computer. Okay, once you copy the file into your machine, now open Questa. So it is opening. Wait for a while. Go to the tools bar, click on it, and go down and look for the option that license setup. So click on this license setup. Here from this tab, again select the license setup. Now Click on these three dots that is asking for your licensing files, which you have grabbed or which you have downloaded from your email. So just give a moment. I will copy this and you will jump straight to that location. Okay, so I will paste the location here. Sorry, just remove this. Okay, so this license file I got over the email ID. So just select it and click on open. Once you do that, click on OK, and that's it. One important note here that when you are configuring the license on your machine for Questa, make sure that Questa is not running at that time on your machine. If Questa would be running on your machine, then this license file or the license may not configure correctly and you would be seeing the error once again. So make sure that Questa is not running at that time while you are configuring the license on your machine. Okay, let's quickly see now that if Questa is working or not. So just open the program areas and search for the option Questa. Click on it. Wait for a while. And this works. So there is no licensing error now. So you can start working now with your Questa as well. Or you can link it with your Quartus Prime and then work it together. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe for regular updates.